Hello, everybody. My name is Vanessa Rivera Quiñones. I'm currently a freelancer and an instructor at the Sagrado Global Data Science and Analytics Program at the Universidad Sagrado Corazón in Puerto Rico. I wouldn't say I was always good at math, but I was definitely drawn to it. One of my favorite teachers in elementary school was my fourth grade math teacher, also called Miss Rivera. And she made math a fun space and safe space for me. And I think that carried me through middle school and high school. And in fact, I ended up going to a high school which specialized in science and math, which meant I took extra math classes each semester, and I really loved it. And I think it's something that started because I felt math was a safe space, but as I kept taking classes, I kept being told, you're good at math, went to competitions, was in the math team, and it sort of got re-emphasized for me that maybe math is something I could be good at. I would definitely say it ties back to my high school experience. When I shared my love for math with my parents or my teachers, they would often recommend that I major in engineering or accounting. And I don't know why I found myself very hesitant to do so. Like, I would always say, I'm going to go study engineering, but with a minor in math. I don't know why, adding the math felt really important. And I think the moment it kind of clicked that, yeah, maybe this is something I should pursue, was that in my senior year of high school, I was lucky to take this research in math class in my school. Since we had extra math classes, there was a research semester. And with my project, I was able to compete in the science fair and eventually made it to the international science fair with my project. And I had never traveled outside of Puerto Rico at all. It was the first time I met other kids that like math and see what else you could do with math. Because I think my experience was a lot of taking extra classes, taking pre-calc, taking calculus, going to competitions, but I had never thought you could do research in math. I felt you just learn all the things they are, and that's math. And I think that really opened my mind. It's like, oh my gosh, there's so many things that you can work on or that aren't unanswered. And I think that was the moment I would like to do that and see how far I can get. So my thesis research when I was in grad school focused on math modeling of disease ecology. And what that means is that we study the interactions between a host, a parasite, and the environment, and especially how these interactions might impact how disease spreads in the system. So my math draws a lot of inspiration from biology and the wider field of epidemiology. And what I do is I use math models, usually involving ordinary and partial differential equations, with computer simulations that allows us to keep track of how populations change over time. So if we think back about what I explained of the host, the parasite, and the environment, we have equations that describe each of them. And then we just see what happens over time, kind of taking into account those interactions. And even though this is a big field in math, math epidemiology, math modeling, applied math, I studied a very specific case. I spent some time working with biology, studying what's called daphnia, and it's this little water flea that lives in Midwestern lakes. And it's really cool because it's kind of clear. So biologists can keep track of the infection process under the microscope. So that's why they find it really interesting. That was mostly what I did in grad school, but currently I've shifted gears a bit. And because I'm a freelancer, I'm sort of thinking about broader projects, and I would love to shift my math modeling skills to sustainability or education, and both through a social justice lens. I think now, my math feels more interesting if it's tied to people. So I would like to make that shift, though it's still an ongoing process. I want to begin maybe by saying like I was always surrounded by people who wanted me to succeed and contribute greatly to doing so. And I felt like the difficulties or struggle that I encountered were personal and mostly related to my mental health in a sense, right? So I had like a lot of anxiety. I was depressed and I was very insecure about myself. And in a sense, this constant encouragement that I received from my environment and my surroundings kind of ended up only like amplifying those feelings. And leading me to kind of feel like an imposter, right? I think in grad school is a very common theme to talk about the imposter syndrome. But for me, it felt like that it was very much tied to the environment or how I perceived myself in an environment. Because even though like I feel like, oh, all these people in my life have provided me these opportunities, and it really kind of felt like I felt like the responsibility to, you know, like do right by them or do right by my community and really sort of then pursue those, right? Like I feel very lucky to have been accepted to my graduate program or to receive funding opportunities from the Ford Fellowship, for example. But I think in the back of my head with sort of my self-perception, that was also like a lot of pressure. I would say my thesis defense, because I, at some point in grad school, I had decided, you know, if this is going to work, I need to make it my way. And I feel like my defense was a celebration of like whatever had happened, like the last 6 years or so. Like my sister came, my family was there over Skype. A lot of my peers came, some of my students. I remember like tweaking my whole presentation the day before. I was like, this is not it. This is not it. So I just kind of start from fresh and like, okay, what do I actually want to say? And I think doing it like that made it very empowering as well, because it felt like, yeah, this is my work. This is the people who I share my work with. And I was able to kind of tie it to my experience there, the organizations I was a part of. So it felt like really like the conclusion of this stage in my life. It was mostly the conclusion of my thesis, but I think that the defense felt like also like a conclusion of that chapter. I feel like I had many role models from the time I was in elementary school all the way up till now. And I was always very inspired by my teachers and professors, but also a little bit by my students, my colleagues, my classmates. I think I draw a lot out of people. Like I find people usually very inspiring, even if they're not necessarily in math. When I think about my career, the quote that always comes to mind is I stand in the shoulder of giants. I think I've always had like that perspective that, you know, I'm only here because of all the people who kind of paved the way and made it possible. And to list them all would be impossible. I think I've tried sometimes and I feel like, oh, then I missed this other person. And there's just been so many in big and small roles. I think sometimes we forget those. You know, you meet someone at conferences that ask a very interesting question and it becomes a project, or then they become your lifelong collaborators. So stuff like that happens a lot, I think, in the math community. And I just find it very interesting and inspiring. And I think like definitely in terms of support, my family has always been very supportive, and also my partner. I think having him in my corner has been really, really nice, because like he's not in the math world, so he gives me a ton of perspective of like, I don't know what it's outside of the math world, I guess. And that has always I feel like my family and my partner have always been like, you know, ride with me. You know, they've been in it for the ride, the good, the bad, the in between. They're always been there for me. And Now I would say I'm very inspired with the people I'm working with. My co-organizers for Math Swagger, I think they're doing great work to advance the community and support students of color. Also, right, my collaborators at Latisms. I think there's some overlap in this group, right? Pamela Harris in particular, but Andres Pindas, also Luis is in Latinism. Alicia, Pito Langarica, Rosaura Toscana Lomeli. I think just being able to work with them has been life changing. Because right, they get the math and we're all excited about the math, but they're also so excited about the people, because for them also, I feel like math is people in the way that it is for me too. So I think seeing, I don't know, mathematicians that kind of bring that to the table as well, it's really life changing. And I'm curious to see how the field is going to change because of it. I think if I were to give some advice is to do something because you like it or you think it's important, and not because you have something to prove or because someone else told you to. I think it's very important to be accountable yourself, right? And empower yourself through that. Definitely choose with what aligns with your values, what feels right to you, and then take responsibility for those choices and their consequences, learn from your mistakes, grow as a person. And I think what really makes a difference is when you surround yourself with people who share your values and who, rather than maybe competing with you, they encourage and help you become the best version of yourself, whatever that may be. It could be math, it could be something else, but those people who really see you for who you are as a whole person, I think those are the people that will really help you grow as a person and as a mathematician. And do the same for them and everyone else, right? Be that person who sees people for who they are and who supports them for wherever they want to become. And hopefully together and in cooperation with one another, we can all succeed in making the world a better place and a best version of itself.